you have portable water. You know, without water, you might not be able to exist. Better. Good food. Let's say food. Let's not say good food. Food. A simple rule. These are the basic work, things you need to live in life. Now, when we talk about the basic economic problems, it means it is affecting, it's affecting what every economy, every state. These problems are the problems every economy is facing. Are we together? They are the problems that are facing every economy in the whole world, no matter how developed they are, or undeveloped, or developing they are. These are the things we're going to talk about tonight. The basic one, economic problem of society. Number one, what to produce. Number one is what to produce. Now, I want us to start from our homes. Let us start from the home, because the home is what? A tributary of what? The economy. Are we together? A home is what? A unit of the economy. Because homes, little homes are the one that comprises what? An economy, or a state, or a local government. Without those homes, you see that the economy will not exist. So, these homes, let us start the example we're going to give from our homes. I'll be able to what? Understand it primarily. Now, look at it. Let's assume my father. My father is 96 now. You will see that. What is his problem now? It's not what I'm thinking. Are we together? What my mom is thinking now is not what I'm thinking. Are we together? Now, let us bring it down to when the whole family is together. Like you are now, you are together. I've left my family. I'm all alone now. So what is in my head is plenty. My dad is there. You're praying any day he dies. Oh, buried it. 97, he has tried. 95, sorry. Now, look at it from the home perspective, so we'll be able to understand in a larger scale what we're going to talk about the basic economic problems of every society. Now, in your home, your dad is the president, true or false? Your mom is the vice president. Are we together? Now, the other siblings, it depends on their range, on maybe male or female, or how they are. You see, senate president, all of them, they have their own contribution to what? To the family. Now your dad has home. Everybody, you see that your dad's headache is what? What are you, okay, let's start from the cooking aspect, because everybody participates from that. This morning, even before this morning, yesterday, what are we going to cook this morning? When you must have finished that headache, what are we going to cook this morning? What? That relates to our bigger economy. What are we going to produce? What exactly do we really want? In your home, what exactly do we really want to eat this morning? What do we need to produce in this house? When that thing is done, the ball might pass to your dad. Okay, look at what we want to do this morning. Look at how much it costs. Look at how we want to do it. We'll come to that. But if you look at that, I'm trying to use our home as a unit, as an example to what we are going to see in the bigger world society. What to produce. Now, if you look at every economy, like I said, they have what, a peculiar problem that they want to solve. If Nigeria is a producing economy, what entails now, what are we going to do is what? What are we going to produce? Remember, human wants are what? Human wants are what? They are numerous. They are unlimited. Have you seen that these things are still coming up now? In every economy, the resources they have is what? The resources they have is what? Is very scarce. Meanwhile, what they want to produce is what? As many as possible. Are we getting the check? Have you seen that the blessings are what are coming back? What do you want to produce? They have a lot of things to produce. Even the most developed nations, US, Canada, whatever, they still have a peculiar problem they are facing. China becomes one of the world's most populous countries. No, it's one of the world's most populous countries, but they were developing, in fact, they have become a developed nation. But look at the problem they are facing now. And what is that? Coronavirus. It's a peculiar problem to them now. So now, you will not say that economy will not be thinking what? How do we handle this matter? What do we produce? They are not going to think of, let us produce cars anymore. Let us produce computers. They are not trying to what? Produce drugs that can be able to tackle coronavirus. Are we together? You will not see that. The simple unit we have in our homes, we are translating it towards a bigger economy. Like in Nigeria, you can testify that insecurity has become what? A problem to the development of this nation. It has become a claw on the wheel of development of this nation. That's why you see militia herdsmen slaughtering people up and down, Boko Haram in the far in the northeast, and whatever, kidnapping up and down. Insecurity has become the problem of this nation. Now, if Nigeria is now thinking about their economic problem on what to produce, you will see that fighting insurgency and insecurity will become the longest in their scale of what? Preference. Are we together? It will become the longest line on the scale of preference. It's not that they don't have any other problems, but this one is what? The one that has what at hand, likewise China. Not that they don't have any problem with these computers, with these other things, but coronavirus is what? What is what dealing with them now? Right now, 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 now. So if you look at their scale of preference in China's things to do or choice, you see that what? Tackling coronavirus become what? Their priority at this point in time. Do you know? China becomes a production hub of the whole world. When you say production hub, everybody goes there to produce. Because of this, now many people what? Because coronavirus is what? It's a communicable disease. It's very deadly. Some people even prefer HIV to coronavirus. Do you know that? Do you know that coronavirus, just spit on my hand and rub here, if I have it, you'll not be any. Touch it, you're gone. You have it. It's a communicable disease. That's why you see, if you've been watching CNN or internet, you see many people, they cover their what? Their nose. If you breathe, if somebody sneezes and you have it. Are we together? And it's very deadly, it kills. So you now see that China's problem now is not how to produce, it's no more the economic hall. That hall. Their problem now is what? How to curtail, how to curb the spread of what? Coronavirus. That is the peculiar problem now. Like in Nigeria, we're not thinking of what to produce. You now see that fighting insecurity or insurgents in the northeast or in the whole country becomes what? The most important thing Nigeria is facing now. You will not see that they are not going to take off. They ordinarily, we're talking about an ideal society, please. When you talk about an ideal society does not exist, but that is what is supposed to what be, not what is on ground. That is how it's supposed to what be. An ideal society will see, if it were an ideal society, Nigeria would not be producing guns and equipment using for fighting insecurity. Are we together? That's what we'll be thinking now. What to produce? I don't know if you're getting what I'm saying. Now, this what to produce comes up because of what? Human and societal needs are what? Numerous. That means they're going to make what? They're going to make what? They're going to make what? Choice. Are we together? They're going to make choice. And that choice will be one that was rational. When they are making choice, they are going to use what their normal parameter, called what? Scale of preference. And make that choice. And when they are making that choice, they are going to what? Look at what is happening today at that point in time. What do we really need at this point in time? Remember what I told you? I said, whatever thing you are doing, you have to put what? A time bracket. At this point in time, what do we really need? In 6 months ago, China never believed coronavirus would hit. So they're not thinking about what? Coronavirus. That's why I said, at that point, what? Time. Are we together? Let that be what? A time span. At that point in time, what they need at this point in time, they're looking at what? Solving coronavirus. What to produce? They have made that choice. Nigeria have made that choice. Because of what? Nigeria have a lot of things to do. Food security, national income, exchange rate, all those things, they are a problem to Nigeria. So, but now, if people are dying, Nigeria will say that, please, oh, let us secure our people. Let us produce more weapons to curtail the insecurity of the nation. I'm not saying that what they will produce, but that is what is supposed to be what? On ground. Are we together? Do we understand the meaning of what to mean by what we talk about what to produce? Do we understand it now?
Yes, sir.
Are you sure it's clear? If we have solved the problem of what to produce, let us go back to our home. We have solved the problem of what do we eat? What do we want to eat this morning? The next step is what? How to do it. I'm happy this class is flowing. I'm impressed. I'm impressed. How do we want to what? Produce it. That means this particular one has been taken care of. It has been what? Taken care of. They have decided this is what we want to produce. That's why you send the Senate, House of Rep members, you send from your home, that they are representing you. They are talking for you. That, whatever thing they say, that's what you say. Whether you like it or not. So they have decided on what? What to produce. Let's assume it's China. China have decided what? With our explanation, to produce what? Drugs to curtail coronavirus. Let's assume it's Nigeria. Senior men. They have produced what? Weapons to fight insecurity. There is something, there is a place in Africa. God like this country. You know why? If you are watching CNN, people are suffering. There's a place in Africa, they have not seen rain for almost 3 years. Do you know what that means? Do you know what it means? Do you know what it means to their agricultural sector? The food production will be what? Will drop drastically. And when that happens, there will be starvation. And they say when the rain wants to come, it will come as a flood and sweep everything away. At this point in time, people like Somalia, they will be reasoning a lot of things. They will fight in starvation. Even when people are dying, because it's only when you eat, that's when you fight, two of us. A hungry man is an angry man. I've not eaten. If you make me vex, please scatter this whole place. But you don't see that? They will be fighting starvation. Seriously. They're not going to think about insecurity. They're not going to think about any other thing. They're not going to think about administration. They're not going to think about any weapon. They are going to think about what? Starvation. Because there is starvation in the land because of what? The natural disaster they are facing. Are we together? Now that's why I say if you continue listening to every economy, they have their peculiar problems. Every economy has their peculiar. So anytime they are thinking of what to produce, they are going to consider those peculiar problems first before looking at the second, third, and fourth ones. Are we together? Now, let us look at other African countries and problems they are facing.
problems they are facing. Some people in Africa, some countries in Africa, HIV is I don't know how to put it.
Most of the problem is that they don't believe that it does exist. Like in South Africa, a learned man will tell you, sorry, that when you sleep, you have HIV, when you sleep with a virgin, it will cure it. It's no madness. It's no madness. You will see that in that particular economy, they have a peculiar problem they are facing. You might think, my brother is in South Africa, it's a better country than Nigeria. You might be lying. Because every economy has what their peculiar problem they are facing. There was a time there was crisis there in South Africa. Many of us must have heard about it. Yes. If you look at the reasons for that, you will know that it's just because of their fear of dominance, you know, foreign dominance. When you're lazy, like I said like some time ago, when you're lazy, foreigner will come and teach you how to manage the economy. See, they are killing blacks, they're mainly Nigerians. Do you know why? Do you know why? They believe government will do everything for them. You know, here, who will not believe in government? Three of us. It's natural. Don't believe in government. Everybody's hustling. Are we getting it? Our men will take that blood to South Africa and they will go there and dominate. They will do business with people who abandon their own shops and come and buy from them. So that fear of, I know that these people are increasing in our own land. That was one of the major reasons for that attack. Nothing else. So that Sokoto have one of the highest, they are one of the highest producers of onion. Yes. Onion. Onion. Are we together? They are blessed with what? Fertile land. Flat land. Now, let's assume they have what? Come to terms of what to produce. They have discussed, they have agreed. So, okay, we're going to produce what? Onion. Now, the next thing that will come in mind is what? How to produce it. On that how, are we going to be mechanized? Are we going to be what? Orthodox farming? Are we going to make it commercial? Are we going to, how do we produce it? Are we going to use tractors in plowing the land, make it a mechanized farming? Are we together? Are we going to use our orthodox farming, use hoes? But whatever decision you are making is based on what? The availability of what? Factors of production. Are we together? The availability of what? Factors of production. That is when you are going to any particular one you want to choose on how to produce, you are going to look at, do we have this? Do we have that? If you have this and that, okay, we can use this. If you don't have this and that, okay, we can use what? The local system of farming. That is how do we want to produce it. Now, let us come to our local unit in our home. When you talk about how you want to produce your local food, you know, there is this. If you want to produce some soup, like in my place, there's a way you do produce it. Are we together? You can use cocoyam. Are we together? You can use cocoyam. Are we together?
Yes, sir.
You can use what they call it, the other one. You guys used to eat now. Don't pretend. Achi and yes, now. You can use that. Are we getting it? Now, before you make that decision, you are going to look at the things you have. Is cocoyam more expensive? Is achi and etc. Are they more expensive? Are they available? If they're available, how much are they? And how much you have? So before you make that decision of how do we want to produce this or has soup, that means you are going to what? To look at the what availability of the other factors of what production in your home. If you consider that, you now make a choice. There is gas oil, there is stove, there is what? Firewood. I use firewood in my house. So, I might borrow stove. You understand? If I want to do small in and that, you know? So, you now check all these things.
when you are looking at that, you will see that before you make that decision, is there gas? If there is no gas, let us buy gas. How much gas can we buy at this point in time? Remember, everything we're talking about is what? At this point in time, not tomorrow, not yesterday. At this point, that's now. How much is gas? How much is 1 kilo of gas? It's around 300 something naira. 1 kg, sorry. How much is 1 gallon of kerosene? That would be enough to keep that. It might be 200 something naira. How much firewood? It might be 100 naira. You make all this analysis and come to terms of the one you want to use. Because at the end of the day, what matters is what the final result. Are we together? You have now decided on what, how to produce. The next level is what? To produce. Whom to produce? Whom to produce? For whom? Yeah, it's okay, all of them are the same thing. Whom to produce? Now, in this particular aspect, we are looking about who gets what and at what percentage. Now, let us come down to our home. You know, I'm the last born in my house. Then, when they're sharing food, being, you know, they will give me my own, no problem. I'll first of all finish it, sharp. I will still go and meet my mother and stay there. I will not say anything. I'll just stay there. She will still eat her own and remain. And when it's not enough, she will go to the pot. But I know it must happen. And my other sister would never agree to that. Say, why do you always eat every time you're eating everything? I said, oh. My mom always refused to say, this food is meant for what? Eating. What's a problem? I like beans so much, and they don't like beans. And when the beans is being isn't produced or being cooked, I would like to eat the lion's share. Because when it remains, some, even when beans is being cooked, I mean, so not the bother, because I know that if they eat once, they will not eat it again. So I will be the one to have the balance of the stock. Now you will not see that. Who gets what in that home? Who gets what? No matter how you see it in your home. No matter how you see it in your home. Your dad or your mom, they have who they like most. They have who they like most. God save you if your dad likes you most. Because you suffer from fear. Because anybody that the mom likes most, now the mom gets kitchen now. So arrangement of food. So who gets what after the food has been what? Produced. What share? Some people get 2 meals, some get one. Now so it be. We are using our homes now, so we'll be able to understand it. Now, in the larger economy, who gets what? And at what percentage are you going to get those things? Now, when we talk about who gets what, let's assume Nigeria have decided to produce weapons to fight insurgents. Now, who gets this report? And which area is it needed most? Can somebody tell us? That's not our question here. Who gets what? We are assuming that Nigeria has what? Decided to produce weapons to fight Boko Haram and Fulani militia. Now, where are those weapons going to be moved to? Which place? Which place?
Not north.
Be specific. Be specific. Too much. No, Adamawa is in the northeast. Not when you say north central, if you say north, we have north central, we have northwest, we have northeast. So not everywhere will get all this weapon. Some places are calm. If you come to Abuja, it's in north central. They don't have plenty of problems about Boko Haram, two of us. So why bringing in the weapons here? Some places need it more. Who gets what? To whom to produce? Who is getting those things that have been produced? Are we getting it? Now, another aspect of it is, remember, day before we talked about what? Distribution.
put together. We talk about what? Distribution. Now, how are those things going to remember? When you talk about distribution, is what? Is what? I explained it here. Is what?
Share.
How do we share those weapons? Who's going to get what? Let's assume we still want to, because definitely there's no harm to produce 1 million weapons and move it all in the northeast. No. Some other places still need some little weapons to work for protection. That's why I said, who gets what at? Because remember, in your home, whenever they, no matter how they hate you rich, they must give you food, three of us. But might not be the same quantity to the other one that's been logged. Are we together? So no matter how the insecurity is in the far in the northeast, all the weapons produced, all of them might not or will not go to the northeast. Some will be reserved for other areas. That's why I said the distribution, who gets what? So at what quantity do you get those things? That means a larger percentage of whatever that's produced will be channeled to the area that had that problem because of what the things that have what produced. Now, in China, there's a place called, what's that town where this coronavirus is very
Wuhan.
Whenever they produce these drugs, you see that most of the drug, most percentage or a greater percentage of the drugs will be moved towards that particular city, true or false. Then we will now leave some to other cities that have one or two cases. You understand? That is how it is supposed to be. Now, when Ebola was ravaging Africa, when I say ravaging, you see that it was disastrous. Liberia was so hit that they were so confused. This culture that when a man dies, the wife will kiss the corpse. It's their culture. You don't say, when we hear our own village culture now, everybody says, in my place, we don't kill viper. Viper. The snake. In my place, we don't kill it. If you just, that is what we came to meet. We have to join. We don't kill it. And then, the animal don't bite us. Viper. As a snake, viper. You know, when viper bites you, goggle it, if viper bites you, something is involved. It's either your hands are not clean. It hardly bites. Viper can stay there and you match on it and you still will not move. It's big, very big and short. It doesn't attack, but it's very poisonous. If it bites you, you might not survive. In fact, most of people don't survive it. So viper don't bite us, don't kill it. Ever hurt you. So, in Liberia, when a man dies, the wife or something, that the way they talk about that story, kills the corpse. And if that doesn't happen, something will start happening in the family. So you can imagine a man that Ebola killed. And if you don't do it, what will happen? The family will. So, it was so bad in Liberia that people were being buried in shallow graves. We call shallow graves. Dogs will go and remove them. And Ebola is another airborne. Everybody just getting it. And when you get it, death. So at that point in time, in the city or the province or the senatorial zone or the state that are worst hit, any drugs produced for Ebola ward, most of the percentage will be channeled to that city. Leaving some other percentage for other people that do not have the virus. But explain for whom to produce, that is the channel or the medium of what? Sharing, distribution.